So guys, today I have something unique. I have the Voltme Dr. Sinor smartwatch, which can measure your body temperature, blood pressure, blood oxygen level, immunity level, and also your ECG. So without further ado, let's check this out. The Voltme Dr. Sinor costs 4,499 rupees for India, and it comes in three different colors of silver, rose gold and black, and comes in this solid cardboard box, and it has all the features on the front of the box and also at the sides, opening which you are greeted with a smartwatch inside. You also get a screen protector, then you get a full size charger, next a small magnetic clip on charger, extra black straps and a user guide is present as well. All these are very nice additions to the smartwatch. Next, let's take a look at the smartwatch. It's made of a zinc alloy metal from the back and the sides and has a 2.5D curved glass on the front. You can easily install the screen protector on the screen by positioning and sticking, and has a 240 by 240 resolution with a 1.6 inch AMOLED screen, which is pretty responsive and works as expected without any issues. And comes with 20 mm silicone straps which are removable and has pins to change. You can use any universal 20 mm straps on these two, and comes with extra black straps as well. The quality of the straps are on par with any leading smartwatch brands in the market. This is also an IP67 water and dust proof and can withstand light rain and showers. Not swimming though. It comes with 200 mAh lithium-ion battery inbuilt and gives about a week's battery life. And there are two types of chargers. One charger in which you need to flip open this and position the watch and close and lock the same for charge. This is nice for charging in your bags or somewhere when there is a lot of movement and can be used as a travel charger when driving, as the other charger is a magnetic charger which locks in place and is good for charging at a stable place like a desk or a home or office. At the back, it has close to 5 to 6 different sort of sensor ports, and also charging pins are here. Now, to get this working, you need an Android or iOS device. Works on Android 10 and below while I reviewed it. This doesn't work on Android 11 and has some issues, but I guess it'll get updates and work better over time. If this is your first time here on Tech Matrix, we do a lot of videos and unboxings, reviews and giveaways on my channel. So hit that subscribe button and also hit the bell icon to get notified for all the new videos and giveaways. First, you need to scan the QR code to download the app or search for Verifit 2.0 app and install the same first. Then register for an account and then set up the details like age, height, weight, gender, metrics and so on, and complete the process fully. Next, go to the profile icon and click on connection management, then click on the Voltme sensor to connect the watch. Now on the main home screen, you get all the activities on top. You get the amount of steps on the left, you get the amount of calories burnt for the day. Clicking on the same expansion shows the daily data, and on the right you get the distance covered. Clicking on the same expansion shows you the daily data as well. Then you get the daily sleep data here. Clicking on it expands and shows detailed sleep data like deep sleep, REM and so on. This will help you understand your sleep patterns better and change some habits. Then you get the heart rate. Expanding gives you details on each measurement taken and shows whether it's normal or not. Then blood pressure for each measurement and also shows normal or not. Blood oxygen level, expanding this gives you a detailed look as well. Then the fatigue, which is basically the stress as well, and expanding shows more details. Then you get the ECG. Once you click, it shows you how you need to hold the tracker. Once you hold it, it will measure, and in history, you can click on the reading. It will give you a full report and has a PDF option which gives you a full ECG report. And at the bottom, you get a measurement conclusion as well, which shows you a range of normal and abnormal, and a full measurement, which is an awesome feature for a watch to have. Next, you have the immunity value, which shows you how your overall immunity level is and gives you a range of the immunity level with a percentage and what it means. and finally body temperature, which shows again through either Fahrenheit or Celsius, and each of the range representation. Each feature has a day, week and monthly showcase, and click on each of these expands further and shows you what the normal and abnormal readings are for each feature. This watch is probably one of the very few which has all these features packed in one. Next tab is a discovery tab, which has friends, which shows all of the friends that are available on the app. Health check-in, which shows you a check-in option where you can enter each of these functions each day, like exercise, go to bed early, eat breakfast, etc. As and when you do one of these, you can punch in each of these. Then you have an exercise tracking function, which records your run with a GPS and adds to the app. Next, a funds for donating and health calculator, which gives you a lots of functions like BMI calculation, metabolism calculation, and many more here. And finally, you get the profile option, where you get the exception detail, which shows any abnormal measurement details all in one place. Then the device management tab, which has find bracelet, add photo, smart reminders, which has call reminders, message, alarm, sedentary reminders, app notifications like WhatsApp or any app notification, and also to set quiet hours as well. Next, you have an option for hand up screen, which basically sets the screen on when you raise your hand. Then an option to measure hourly, all the features automatically. Then show screen saver. Next, you have the settings tab, which has other things like 12-hour system, third-party access, etc. The watch, however, has fewer functions. On the top, you have heart rate monitoring. Clicking on it expands, and blood pressure as well here. And then you get SpO2, which is oxygen saturation. And then you have immunity levels. And going down, you have training, which has a lot of other training options. And then the messages option. And then you get weather as well here. And then you get the QR code to connect. And then at the bottom, you get the body temperature and ambient temperature and find phone option as well. And then also you get a timer here on the watch, which is not available. And in the settings, you get the brightness option to increase and decrease the brightness, mute switch. And then you also have a switch style to change the style of the watch. And then clicking on this will ensure that you have a different screensaver or the watch style every time. And then going into settings again, you also have reset and power off here as well. All in all, these features are very good. The only drawback for me is the app, which has some bugs and not up to mark with other apps out there as of now, and has advertisements running in the background and has pop-up ads too from time to time. But I guess it will receive updates as well over time and can get better over time. So guys, what do you think about the Voltme? Tell me in the comment sections below, and also hit that like button and subscribe for more such geeky videos. This is Bharat. Peace out.